There are a number of candidates in Leaf camp vying for a job on the top line alongside captain Mats Sundin, including one unlikely. Tough guy Wade Belak says he's throwing his hat into the ring. Well, somewhere near the ring. Now, why would a player who has made a career as a tough guy, or goon if you will, suddenly think he should be on the top line?
Yes, I put in my time. I've never been higher than the fourth line. So I've put in my time and I deserve number one.
Belak put in his time playing a role he says was forced on him when he first entered the NHL.
I had no say in what was going on. They just sat me down and they molded me into being this person.
Like a machine, Belak was programmed to fight. But with all of the changes to the game in recent years, he finally decided it was time he made some changes as well.
Basically, I have to reprogram myself and start from scratch with the basics.
What do you mean by the basics?
Well, you know, like shooting, passing, stick handling, stopping.
Stopping?
Get down and turn, 2 foot stop, pivot, knee down, explode.
Believe it or not, after years of concentrating on nothing but winning fights, Belak's skills have diminished in some of the simplest areas of the game. This summer, he was almost militant about retraining himself.
Head up, body position, knees bent. Accelerate.
But despite all of Belak's hard work, his peers are still very skeptical.
Yeah. I know Wade is a great skater and a big, tough guy, but I don't know about the top line.
Belak is not surprised by his teammates' lack of confidence. He believes he's been stereotyped as nothing but a dumb goon. Belak also believes if he is successful in changing his game, it may go a long way in changing people's perception of fighters.
I know, that's definitely the stereotype they put us in. And I don't think it's very fair, because I think we are very smart. I think if you just ask me anything right now, I could probably give you the right answer.
All right, what's the square root of 73?
Square root of 73. Well, you know, math isn't really my strong point.
But despite Belak's shortcomings in math, he has no problems crunching the numbers he believes he can put up if given a chance to play on the top line.
I figure if I play on the top line, I'll get like, I don't know, 30 goals, 40 assists. That's about 100 points, I figure.
And Belak believes this will result in Sundin's numbers skyrocketing as well.
I feel very, very confident in my ability to feed him the puck in all situations. I'll be streaking down the wall. He can hang up high. I'll do a little tight spinorama on the hash marks. I know exactly where he's going to be.
Got to be able to find him at all times. Without looking at him. Look at that. Right out to him. In. It's years of watching him on the bench.
The question now is, with all of those years of watching from the bench, will Belak earn a closer view this season? Greg Ross, Sportsnet, Toronto.
One night and defense the next. That's a great luxury for a coach. Tonight, he's a forward.
He's with
McCauley. Two nights ago, he's a defenseman.
And Volk up on the right side.